I will subscribe everything that we talked before, because I think that all of us has this problem with the documentation and this. We have a lot of work to do, and it's not that it's something that Cedric or Nico have to do. We can help, but maybe we don't know how. And if we can build a wiki, or it doesn't matter the technology, but maybe if we, after this conference and spring, we say it's here. Go. Maybe we can build something. I am sure that we build something better than we have now. that's important. Okay. First of all, we lunch up to 12:30 here. Okay. Who want? If not, you can go when you were. And after that, 1 hour up to, it's 2 o'clock or 1:30, no? We return here, okay? I will try to speak in name of other people and company that work in the Triton localization for Argentina. The errors are mine, and you can talk, because I am trying to talk not like Jacob or like Pablo, if not how to build a localization. Well, who we are? In Triton Argentina, in last year, we grow a little more. We are more than three software companies, little three software companies, or people, programmers, that are working with Triton, a lot of them in an early stage of adoption of Triton. Yes, I think that a lot of our companies, are cooperative, because we have a federation of free software cooperatives of workers, and a lot of us make that trip. Okay. From OpenERP, we started with OpenERP, and we passed to Triton. In Jacob, we start with Triton 2.4. But there is a little community of Triton, but it's growing a lot. And we have a little community of Auto 2. I think that it's more little than the Triton community. We have a lot programmers here. We have some people who make services with Auto. And we have a local free software ERP. It's a company of the Patagonia region that the base was at Empire, and they built an Argentinian product. That's the market of the little market of the free software ERP here in Argentina, I think. Okay, we are trying to maximize our efforts. Okay, we know we have no Timbra a lot years ago. They know us. We have another programmers and company that are trying to work with Triton, and well. Some years ago, we say, okay, we have our account R, our invoice R, Timbra has those of them, another one has another, and we try to build the Triton Argentina and to put all together and to maintain some modules of the localization. We try to work together, to have regular meetings, not all month, but we are trying to do that. We have a site, not updated, but we have a site. We try to make a documentation and a site, and all we was talking late after this talk. And well, we have a site with not all the information that we can make. And we will try to have update our localization, updated by our localization. We are in the 3.4. We will go to 3.8 in next days. And we put this like a rule. We will try to update it all in November with the Triton Conference. We will have the localization updated. But I want to go some years ago, because I was in a talk of Cedric, and I really liked that talk, and I agree. And the talk was, why you should not do localization modules. And that was in Barcelona, and was very useful for us. And I say, well, why we have localization modules? And I think that it's similar that we talked earlier, and that's the spirit of this talk, that we can, maybe we need something in countries because we have some regulation on that, but we have to talk more to improve what we have in common, to have something better in common, and to put the less necessary code in localization. That's the spirit, because that's talk say why you should not do localization modules. Well, we need to work together, please. That we agree with that. And if you work in localization, you have a limited audience, and you are always duplicate effort. And well, that's the point of the start of the trip. We agree with that, and maybe we want to go with in this tuba. We want to end with the roadmap that say, well, this is a localization because we need, and this is what we can make together to improve Triton in core modules or whatever, and to limit our localization, because it's very difficult to maintain it too, for Chimbra, for us, and that. Well, I will explain a little what we have in our localization, and after that, I don't know, maybe on Tuesday we can say, okay, this could be in this problem we have in Brazil, or we have in Colombia, and maybe can be in core, or we can share effort to improve it. Okay, our need is not only account. We don't have we have an XML with our Argentinian account, but it is not the problem. It's not the core of the localization, because we have some other issues. We need a point of sales. I will show later, because here in Argentina, a company have different point of sales because they have different cash machines, or because they have different ways to make an invoice, electronic, manual, or they have different shops and all of that.
Yes, just a remark. We are not talking about a point of sale in the,
yeah,
like we know in the other efforts, like the six. We are talking about a legal field that is required in the invoice. It's called point of sale.
Yeah, it's not the point of sale that had in Spain in that module, that is point of sale. And we have in that point of sale, we have different type of invoices with different sequence, each invoices and each type, and for each point of sale. Okay? After that, we have electronic invoice, central administration of Argentina. I don't know how to say. AFIP is the law of the administration. Has web service that you have to consult and to make an invoice, electronic invoice, and we have a module to do that. We integrate it with Timbra and a library that the Python programmer make. He's in Picon now to integrate Python with the AFIP, with the authority of Argentina. We have a entity verify. You can change. Ask AFIP if the entity, the client, is regular, is registered or not. You do that with the ID of VAT number. We have a voucher ad that Timbra makes, that it's not only voucher because you can register a payment with tax retention and something particular of Argentina, but maybe that is a module that we can share effort with others. Because it's a voucher with some particular. We have taxes reports, monthly reports that it's not report only, you have to share an interface to AFIP authorization to say how much you have to pay of taxes. And we have not yet we didn't make it yet, but payroll, a lot of companies need payroll, and there is an Argentinian way to unions and company discuss and make the payroll, and maybe there is something of the localization there. This is our report. We have account app, we have account invoice app that has the post, the electronic invoice, and integration with the authority. We have some tutorials and documentation. We have a deploy localization Argentina, and it is not the only one because we have a lot of companies that make their own tutorial. I think that we have 3 or 4 tutorials and 10 ways to do things in Argentina. And we always say, well, this is the tutorial, and after that, I see Cilix has one, Bitson has one, Debeco has one, we have one, Timbra has, o sea, there are a lot of ways to say this is installation, and we always have the email, how I can start writing. For that reason we have to share effort, because we make 10 different and we are not clear at all, because they say, oh, I have a problem. I can deploy the Triton with the Argentina localization that needs some libraries or that things to connect to the authority. We have a bank app that Cilix make, and now the module bank of Triton, maybe we can share there. And we have a voucher app with these particulars. I take some pictures to be clear about the post or the point of sales. We have a client, and but we have different point of sales, and we have different type of invoice in that point of sales, and each type of invoice has different segments. For that reason, we need to have this to administrate, because you are in the electronic point of sales, you will consume that web service of the authorization. We have different web service when you make an export services or in the local market. And you have different type of invoices with different invoice for each point of sales. this is the core of our localization module, because here we have the Argentina integration out there. Well, in the electronic invoice, we have this, that we have an ID that the authorization give us, that is, that's invoice is okay, and well, we have we log all the communication with the authority if we have any problem with the request or the response to trace back. Okay, but well, we have another tab in the invoice to manage all the communication and to put the number of the invoice when the authority say it's okay with that ID. Okay, this is our core. We have another modules that are not in the localization yet, and maybe they are in a localization because we and a lot of people here work in cooperative, because we think that free software, I will not talk about this now, but we think that the free software cooperative, free software philosophy has a lot of common with the cooperative, and programmer here make a lot of companies like a cooperative, workers cooperative, and we make a module for that because we have some difference like that other companies, and we need a receipt that is not payroll, but it's similar to payroll, but it's not payroll because we are not employees. We need that, and we want to share our meetings because we have meetings of the company, and we need to manage the vacation and that issues of that it's not employee but it's similar, and we really really want to use the social balance, that it's an idea in the world that company can make a social balance to show what they do for the community, and a cooperative has a lot of theory about social balance in cooperative, because we are companies that don't want to earn money the company, if not the people who work there, but with some principles, and you have to prove that you are making them principles in your work. And well, we mix the analytic accounting of Triton and make a social balance with that, and we all of that put in a module of cooperative. We have an account payment. We will try to put in Triton Argentina as soon. That set a pay mode to an entity, because it's very useful for us, because we are using Triton for our administration, but for all of clients need to know which is the pay mode of the client. Okay, they need to know if they will pay. We have some client that make services, and they need to know if they will, if the client pay with this credit card or that one or this other, because all months they will debit on the credit card or in the bank account automatically. They want to make that, and well, you need to know the pay mode of that entity. Okay, we made that, and we made that with for one bank here. That and all credit card, Visa, we have another credit card here, this Cabal, MasterCard, because each one have different interfaces that you have to give them, and they return you someone in FTP and other issues. You send an achievement, and they they return if they can make the debit or not. Well, that's account payment. You know that the client have this account payment, and the payment collect that, send and return this issue. You know, you have a lot of clients that use different credit card or bank debit, and you can manage there. You have a monthly archive for each type of credit cards, and after that you process to pay all the invoices if the credit card can make the debit. Okay, this is not Argentinian at all, but we can't make it in Triton. This is for any company that want to sell services and need to automatize the monthly invoices. Well, to finish, I want to return to the beginning. Our idea is which of these modules or this functionality is in other countries and is necessary to share with Triton community in general or with other to have less in our localization and more in Triton. Our goal now is to reduce localization to go to core modules or other countries with similar requirements. Maybe with Spain we have a lot of similar. I talk in Brazil, we have a similar requirement too. We will go to 3.8 next day, and we will try to continue the growth of our community. Well, thanks. I don't know if I have a question. Thanks.
For your post field on the invoice, is it not just a journal?
I think no, because we have the, I will go here. We need the post. There you have to say which type of post is that, if manual or electronic or that. After that, you have to, if you want to make electronic invoice, you have to customize the website that you want. And after that, you need different type of invoice with different sequence in that post.
Yes, but I think in Spain, they have also the needs of having different sequence depending of the type, and probably also depending of the journal, if it's to sell or purchase journal. But I think you could probably merge at least one level instead of having your journal, the post, and the type. You can probably join the journal and the post and still have the type of invoice, because you cannot find it other way, and get the sequence from the journal with this kind of similar list.
Maybe. Yes. We will have Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. No, because we want to put in click on data, and maybe, yeah. I don't know how to journal works exactly for these inputs, but and how to do it for so many seconds, but it's not a big size, it's only that we need different sequences for different type of invoice in different points of sales.
Maybe it be shared with the Spanish needs.
Okay. we will join. Yeah.
Yes, sorry, I think it's a little tricky in our case because the POS here, the point of sales, are different concepts. I think it should be divided from the journal because, for example, in a company you could have 100 point of sales because every fiscal printer could be a point of sale. And that's a legal requirement, not a company's decision. In that case, you should have 100 journals, for example, and I think for the accountant place, it could be really hard to manage. In that case, it's not viable, at least here in Argentina, for certain kind of companies. But, of course, if you have 2 points of sale, there is no problem to use a journal. But I think there are very different concepts. Also, the point of sale is determining the invoicing method. Okay? Here we could have, as Paulo said, manual invoices for little companies. We could have these fiscal printers, which are not regular printers. And we could have electronic invoice and so on. So every day, the government could create a new one, and we need to run. So if we merge the journals and the posts, we are merging two different concepts. For one side, we have the accounting with our beautiful taxes and other things. And for the other side, we have the administration of the company, which are two divided departments, at least of general here in Argentina. And that's the thing I see a little tricky to merge, but of course, it's probable, and we should study the case, at least for some local cases.
Yeah. I think that the idea of the point of sale is present in all the countries of the region. I think in Brazil, we talk about that in two. In Uruguay, I think it's true, and we have different point of sale and different sequence for invoice. And for that reason, I don't know if it's a good reason to have a Triton core module to resolve this or our shared core.